So here come the officials for the second of our finals, the men's singles final here. An old Chinese affair. Du Penyu up against Chen Long, the number one and two seeds. And two and three, of course, in the world rankings. By the service judges being announced to the crowd, as will the players very shortly.
Let's give a very warm welcome to the MVP for the men's singles final. 让我们以最热烈的掌声欢迎男子单打决赛选手进场。
Well, here's Chen Long. And it's going to be interesting to see what happens here, because there has been some talk that Chen Long here is suffering a little bit with an injury. Yeah, we understand it could well be a shoulder injury. This match was actually due to be the fourth match on, and because of that problem, it has been moved up the schedule to number two. How bad and severe it is, we'll have to wait and see, but you have to say, having said what I have said, and given the speculation, maybe this man is a favourite to win this title, Du Penyu. If you look at the results, who is favourite here? Chen Long, who's been on this wonderful run of form, up against the man who just can't cross the finishing line. Repeat of last year's semi-final. Of course, both players do have both bronze and silver from this event, but neither yet to win a gold. Obviously, I'm going to keep an eye on how Chen Long is hitting. Seven times in total. Chen Long has won four of them. Here is Chen Long. Look at that win-loss ratio, 11-1. The only one he lost this year was in Korea, where he retired in the first game, in the first round. Nine Super Series titles now. Won the All England in March, beating Lee Chong Wei in that match that lasted an hour in Birmingham. Our umpire is Cheng Jingku. Service judge Lin Yi Su. Well, there is how it went last time at the end of last year in the Super Series final. Chen Long winning that one. 21-12, 21-13. Du Penyu did win the other two meetings though in 2012. Including last year's Badminton Asia Championship semi-final, won 21-12 in the final set. They also met in the semi-final of this event in 2009. Chen Long won that one, 21-16, 28-26. Well, he looks to be moving okay. Now you can see a little bit of plaster there around the right hand back of his neck that goes down towards his shoulder. This is how they have got there. Du Penyu matching up against Wang Zhengming yesterday and didn't have to play the full match because Wang retired in the second set. Good match it was between Chen Long and Chong Wei Feng. He really pushed Chen Long in that semi-final. So we're just about ready to get underway then for the second final here. Fit is Chen Long. How long can he last? Can he go the distance? Can he win the crown? Wu Penyu with a wonderful moment to claim his first major title. No Super Series wins, no Grand Prix victories. He's had 7 defeats in finals since the start of last year. Looks from Chen Long up at towards the lighting. Du Penyu has admitted he's found it a little bit difficult to judge the drift in this arena. But he started in just the fashion he would have wanted. Again, looks up towards the lights. He's not comfortable. Whether that's something to do with the injury that I've mentioned on a few occasions already, or not too sure, but. The bridesmaid, never the bride so far, Pen Yu. There's Li Chongwei. Lin Dan, of course. Chen Long now, dominant, and then there's the rest, and this man has led the pack, toured away out of the limelight. You get the feeling here, given the information I've given you. Today could be Du Penyu's day. Players, you just saw there, did you? After that point, Chen Long just doing a little rotation of his arm, just trying to loosen up his shoulder a little bit. There's no doubt he's not feeling 100% here. Take nothing away though from that shot from Du Penyu. I'm sure Du Penyu is aware of Chen Long's issues. Oh. Oh. And he's playing some sublime badminton. Absolutely perfect. Just wide this time. In the previous matches, no coaches on the sideline, seeing it's a whole Chinese affair. No Li Chongwei here this week. We did see Lin Dan, and he won a couple of matches before pulling out ahead of his quarter final with Wang Jingming. He cited a shoulder injury. Lovely net play. Singles has been totally dominated by China over the last 4 years in the Badminton Asian Championships. Lin Dan winning in 2010, Bao Junlei 2009, Lin Dan again 2011, Chen Jin last year. Just got to ram home his advantage here, Duke. End of 2009, he was 165th in the world rankings. End of last year, up to five, now third. Major final. He just can't stop winning at the moment. Well, yeah, he said at the start of this match that given the circumstances, given what we think is the case with Chen Long, that Du Penyu is the favourite here, and he's asserted his authority in the early stages of this match. The interval lead is his by 11 points to 6. In heads-to-heads between these two. That's in. Chen Long looks quizzically towards the line judge there, but in it was. lovely rally, and just the miss hit from Du Penyu, allowing Chen Long to wrap it all up. He's got a lot of strapping on, a lot of tape on his right arm and shoulder, Chen Long. The rallies are getting good here, aren't they? Misjudged it again. It was comfortably in. Well, when you're not feeling 100%, you lose your feeling of invincibility, which he's bound to have had. I mean, take away what happened in Korea. He is, when he retired in the first round, he has been on an amazing run. This time it is out. And Chen Long, of course, won the All England, won the German Open in his previous event, ended 2012 winning the last three events of the year. So Korean Open apart, he's won 31 matches in a row. But the way things are going here, he's about to lose this one. It's still the early stages of the match, but everything not going right at the moment for Chen Long. Placed. Lovely drive to Chen Long's backhand. There was no doubting his talent, Du Penyu. All muscle and hustle, a gutsy physical player, really. Maybe not as talented as the likes of Chen Long, Lin Dan, but he's shown his rise up the world rankings that he has that ability. He'll tense up. Here he gets to winning sets in the match. It'll get tense. Pressure will be there on him. One thing that he can take advantage of, Chen Long. Excellent block by Chen, but well, that was just in. Thought for a moment that was going long. Not of approval from the umpire. Comfortably in. Is better. 3 points in a row now. Things getting a little tighter.
nicely played. Oh, he's at the court gaping. And he didn't find it into the net from Du Penyu. Maybe just tensing up a little. Four points in a row now. And what seemed a really big gap in this opening set has now become a bit of a tiny one, certainly in comparison. Gets to winning sets, the nearer he gets to winning matches, each point becomes that little bit harder, doesn't it, for Du Penyu? But he's got another one now. And I think that's the way he's got to play it, stay aggressive, carry on playing the kind of points he was early on in this match. Little touch shots, they're the ones that become harder when you're feeling a bit nervous. Just wide. Excellent. Has played those really well. It was a little short from Chen Long. Again. So four game points for Du Penyu. A chance to really seize the initiative in this men's singles final. And it's just wide. Wide from Chen Long, and the opening game does go to Du Penyu. How much this is to do with the suspected injury for Chen Long? Well, can only speculate, but he's one game away now from his first victory in the major stakes. Du Penyu taking the opening set 21 points to 17.
just about to start the second set, and a little bit of moisture on the court needs to be mopped up. So is this Du Penyu's moment? His only major win is the World University Championships, but this could be his time in the sun here in this Taipei arena. Already a set up now, a point up in the second set. Lovely badminton on display in that rally. Seeing some typical Du Penyu action there in the end. Could pull off the smash. But, bouncing up with his recovery shots. Got those ones right on the hole in this final so far. An apology from Du Penyu there. It was actually very well played. There was no need to apologize at all. And already establishing a decent lead here in this second set, Du Penyu. No, he left it. And he shouldn't have done. It was well placed. Shot of a player not at 100%. World number two up against it here. Frustrated now, Chen Long. He's making the errors as well. Strange looking shot that from Du Penyu. Got that all wrong. Timing was out there. Well, 2 years in a row, lost in the semi-final stage. Also lost in a final as well of this championship as Chen Long. As of course did Du Penyu a year ago to Chenjin. Got it back to 7-0 now. Four of the five last points have gone Chen Long's way. Well, that was pretty emphatic. Great hit from Du Penyu with the smash. Who needed that one? You don't see Chen Long missing these ones too often, do you? Slipping out of his fingers. Yeah, can you just see there? Can you see the tape around his neck there, Chen Long? Not uncommon to see badminton players with their legs bandaged up and tape everywhere, but there's a lot of strapping on that right shoulder. Still tried to get back for that one, Du Penyu, but that was really well played by Chen Long. Stepping it up a bit there, Chen Long, and then a little rub of his shoulder. In a row to take Chen Long into the interval with an 11-10 advantage, and maybe he's not done and dusted just yet. Thank you. well left by Du Penyu. Some big points coming up for him here. He's playing an opponent who may not be at full strength, but who still can be pretty dangerous. Oh. It's long again. To be out, wasn't it? Well, changed his mind too late. And again, another feel of the shoulder from Chen Long. There's no doubt he is being hampered here. The world number two by injury. Take nothing away from Du Penyu, because he's got a wonderful opportunity here to win this championship. Again. Yeah, you see that little flex of the shoulder there from Chen Long after the shot. Five of the 6 points since the interval have gone Du Penyu's way. Really solid play from Du Penyu. Flat exchanges there. Well, it has been a long time coming. It doesn't matter who he's faced in the final, Du Penyu. He's just not been able to come out on top, but he is well on top now. 17-12 up, 5 points his advantage, 4 points away from victory. It's long again. Given out. Now cruising, Du Penyu. Crowd sensing what on paper seems an upset, but I think given the circumstances, less so. How aware they are of Chen Long's struggles, I'm not too sure. Two more points required. That's a long way back here for Chen Long. This is the first of three all Chinese finals today. Chen just can't bring himself match point. He understandably tensing up a little here. Got a little room to manoeuvre with, though. Excellent from Chen Long. That's more like it. Need a bit more of that, doesn't he? Excellent smash and quickly pouncing with Du Peng Yu having to recover. It's match points for Du Peng Yu. Into the net from Chen Long. And is this what Du Peng Yu has been waiting for? The 25-year-old here is standing on the edge of victory. Failed to take, he still has three more. Down into the tension, change of the shuttle required. Wide, well wide. And for the cheeks, a little bit of exasperation from Du Peng Yu. Four match points now, two. Got it over the net, and it's now down to 19-20. Such small margins. Was I going to miss this one? It's a final breakthrough for Du Peng Yu. He has his victory at last. Chen Long may not be fully fit, but take nothing away from the new champion, the 2013 Badminton Asia champion is Du Peng Yu, 21-17, 21-19.